The next rule we're going to look at for exponents is the power rule. The power rule says that if you have x to the a and you raise that to another power, that you get x to the ab. In other words, when you have powers raised to powers, you multiply them. So if you had x to the second raised to the fourth, that would be x to the eighth. Let's see if that makes sense. This base to the fourth power means you have x to the second, x to the second, x to the second, x to the second. Each one of these is x times x. Altogether, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I have x to the 8th. So the rule does make sense. There are some little additions to the rule, and it says if you have a product, say x to the a, y to the a, and you raise the product to another power, that you multiply both of them. It's x to the ab, y to the ab. It feels a little bit like distributive property, even though it's not. Excuse me. The rule also says if you have a quotient, x to the a over y to the a, and you raise that to the b, that both the numerator and the denominator of the quotient get raised to the power, x to the a times b, y to the a times b. So the power rule says powers raised to powers, and there will always be parentheses, you multiply the exponents. All right, let's take a look at some of those. First one, it has pq raised to the 12th power. Well, p is going to be raised to the 12th, q is going to be raised to the 12th. So it's p to the 12th, q to the 12th. I actually did use the power rule because these both had implies exponents of 1. So 12 times 1 was 12. All right, next one. I have 4m to the 5th raised to the 3rd power. Every factor gets raised to the 3rd power. That's going to be 4 to the 3rd power. M to the 5 times 3 is 15. Now, in some settings, you could leave the answer like that. I'm pretty sure MathLab will want that coefficient multiplied out. 4 times 4 is 16, times 4 again is 64m to the 15th. Let's look at more. I have p to the 5th, q to the 2nd, raised to the 8th power. Well, the power rule says that each factor gets raised, so that's p to the 5 times 8 is 40, q to the 2 times 8 is 16. Next one, I have negative 8, a to the 4th, b to the 5th, c raised to the 2nd power. Because the 8 is negative, I'm going to put it in parentheses. It is the negative 8. It was in parentheses in the big expression. Then it's a to the 4 times 2 is 8, b to the 5 times 2 is 10, c to the implied 1 times 2 is 2. Now, negative 8 times negative 8 is 64, a to the 8th, b to the 10th, c to the 2nd. Let's look at a few more. All right, I have r over s raised to the 9th power. This part of the power rule says that the r will get raised to the 9th and the s will get raised to the 9th. And I really did multiply because it was an implied 1 there and an implied 1 there. Number 6 takes a little further. I have mp over n raised to the 8th power. Every factor on the top and on the bottom get raised to the 8th power. So it's m to the 8th, p to the 8th, over n to the 8th. You're going to have to use both the fraction tool and the exponent tool on that. Our last problem has negative 5 x to the fifth z over y to the fifth all raised to the third power. Every factor in here needs to be raised to the third power. That's going to be negative 5 in parentheses to the third power, x to the 5 times 3 or 15th power, z to the implied 1 times 3 or third power over y to the 5 times 3 or 15th power. The only thing then that you're going to need to do is actually raise negative 5 to the third power. Negative 5 times negative 5 is 25 times negative 5 is negative 125 x to the 15th, z to the third, over y to the 15th. You're going to have to be real careful typing this in to MathLad using the fraction tool to start with and then the exponent tool several times.